I know what you're thinking. Another 20-something-year-old girl that's trying to start a YouTube channel. How original, right? I hate myself too. That's pretty much all I have to say about that. So today, what I really wanted to do, since it's 2019 and I don't really have a resolution, but I kind of decided that maybe I should be more positive this year, because if you know me at all, I'm a super positive person. So basically what I want to do is tell you guys 19 things for 2019 that I hate. And the reason I want to do that is because I feel like if I talk about things I hate, it'll get it out of my system, and then I can just be more positive throughout the year of 2019. That's the goal. I have no clue if it's going to work, but let's do it anyways. So first thing, sparkling water. It tastes like dog. My apologies to those of you that like LaCroix and stuff. Maybe you just like it because LaCroix is fun to say. I understand that. When you're trying to find a parking spot in a crowded parking lot and you think you see one up pretty close, so you pass up a bunch of good old parking spots that could have worked for you, and then you get to this spot and there's a car there. It's just a short car. A car that was so short that you couldn't see it, and that I hate, okay? Apple Music. I've never used it. I just don't like it. Heating your food in the microwave way too long and then immediately eating it because you have no patience or self-control. That sucks. Being in a building with more than 30 people in it. Doesn't matter the size of the building, I don't really care. If there's more than 30 people in it, I don't want to be in that building. Stores at the mall with multiple exits. Dillard's, Macy's, JCPenney's, stores like that in the mall that have like 4 exits and you can't find the one that you came in. I have gone into Dillard's trying to get just to like the mall part of the mall, just because I parked near Dillard's and I wanted to get into the mall, and I'd spent 30 minutes trying to find my way out of Dillard's and into the mall. Don't know which side of Dillard's I parked on. Why do I keep doing it? Why do I keep parking there? I don't know. When you're driving and there's a cop driving behind you, it's like immediately you think you're gonna start doing illegal things. You don't usually, but like, what if you do now? I'm paranoid, and if there's a cop behind me, my heart rate is over 100. I don't know, sometimes I feel like, you know what, never mind. The saying, you can't have your cake and eat it too. What the f does that mean? Never understood that saying. Please someone explain it to me. I don't get it. Let's stop saying it. The juice that comes out of packaged chicken. I don't think I need to elaborate on that one. Sweatpants that don't have pockets. I want to be comfortable and be able to carry things in my pockets. Why do they exist? Throw them away, get rid of them, hate them. Paying for shipping on literally anything. I refuse to pay for shipping. I don't know, but I don't want to pay for it. I'll put stuff in my cart, I'll be ready to check out, and it'll be like, you're $50 away from free shipping, and I'm like, I would rather have $50 worth of more stuff than pay for $3 of shipping. The series on Netflix that only have one season and you have to wait an entire year for the next season to come out. It's very upsetting because I don't usually check beforehand to see like how many episodes there are gonna be. And then sometimes you get to episode 8 and you don't even realize you're on the last episode. And now you have to wait a year before you even find out what happens next. And if it's a cliffhanger, so help me God. The fact that Dateline's not just on TV 24/7, I love Dateline. If it's not on, I'm sad. It pretty much is on all the time. I wanna wake up, Dateline. I wanna sit down for my coffee, Dateline. That's the same thing. Go to bed watching Dateline. I love Dateline. The next one is Aldi's. I know people love them some Aldi's, but I hate it. I went there for the first time a couple weeks ago, and as someone that just doesn't like to go new places because they're scary, it was terrifying, okay? Everything moves fast. You have to know what you're doing. You have to put a quarter in a cart to get a cart. I didn't know that. I don't know why I hate it. It's scary. You know, ever since the last video when I decided that my eyebrows were too far apart, I can't unsee it. This next one hits near and dear to me because I love ice cream. It is impossible to get ice cream in any town, anywhere, after 10 p.m. It is so hard to get ice cream. Everything closes at 10. Why? I don't know. Oh, it's 10:15 and I really want ice cream. Guess what? Nothing's open. That's it. And I don't want grocery store ice cream. I want the good ice cream. It's very upsetting. Cups that don't fit within the confines of the dishwasher row. Ew. Now, that might not bother most of you. I have self-diagnosed annoying OCD. I have to have cups that fit in the little in a little rose. It's a problem. I'm sorry to my roommates that have to deal with me, but I really don't like it. That guy from the Avengers movie. If you don't know who I'm talking about, this one, I don't know his name. I don't know if I can even put the picture here, so I don't know why I'm doing that. I'm acting like I have like editing skills. This guy looks like, now buckle your seatbelt, Voldemort, Squidward, and Randall from Monsters, Inc. morphed together and had a child, and it is this hideous, mean creature. Spoiler alert, he died in the movie. I don't care. He scares me and he's weird. This stuff. Now, weird story about this. I actually bought this from Target, and it's Target brand, and I was using it for weeks, and like, I didn't really think much of it, but I was like, man, it's like kind of like building up right here. Like there was stuff like squirting out, like it would be squirting on my mirror and I'd be like, that's kind of weird, like it should be going in my nose, you know. I had the cap on. I wish I was kidding about that, but that's a true story, and I realized it when I was about to complain to Target and say how bad their packaging was and their nasal spray was, and then I realized that I was using it with literally with the cap on. So sorry, Target, that was my bad. Garages that are like basically too small for anything but the car, how are you supposed to get in and out of your car? Songs with dance moves that you pretty much have to learn, or you can't go anywhere and hear that song and like not do the dance. If you do the wrong dance, you better just die because it's embarrassing. The only time this was cool was back in the day when Hoedown Throwdown by Hannah Montana was a thing. That dance was lit. I loved it. It was fun. Brings everyone together. Still a movement. Let's bring it back. That darn nasal spray not really doing its job. I'm just kidding. I haven't used it in weeks because it's winter. Why do I have allergies? I don't even know if I've done 19 things. Is anyone counting? Let's listen to Hoedown Throwdown just because I want to. Okay, who's ready? Alright, I'm over that. Alright guys, well that's about it for the 19 things I hate for 2019. Maybe you agreed with like one or two. Some of them I think I'm just kind of weird, so I don't really know how to end a video, so bye! You guys, I literally catfished you guys. You wanna know why?